Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today I'm talking about relative error, percent of error, and tolerance. This is the first of a two-part video. When you're working on a project, it's important to determine measurement error. The relative error of a measurement is found by dividing the greatest possible error by the measurement itself. And we've talked about greatest possible error already, but to refresh you on that, the greatest possible error, I'm going to call it GPE here just for shortness, is found by dividing the precision of the measuring instrument by 2, or whatever your precision is, divide by 2. So if your precision was 0.001, then the greatest possible error would be 0.0005, because 0.001 divided by 2 is 0.0005. So we just take whatever the precision is, divide by 2, and that gives us our greatest possible error. So we're going to take the greatest possible error and we're going to divide that by the measurement itself, and that's going to give us our relative error. So for instance, let's say that your measurement was 2.4 meters. What's the precision here? Well, the precision is to the second decimal place. That's the 100th place. So it's 0.01 or 100th, because the last significant digit, is which is 4, is in the 100th place. So what's the greatest possible error? Well, we take our precision, which is 0.01, and we divide by 2, and we get 0.005. So now all we're going to do to find the greatest possible error, the relative error is the greatest possible error divided by your measurement. I left a T off there. Divided by your measurement. So our greatest possible error was 0.005, and your measurement was 2.14. If I divide those, I get 0.00234. The percent of error is just the relative error that we just found expressed as a percent. And remember that when we want to find a percent, when we're given a decimal number, we just move that over 2 places to get our percent. So what is the percent error for the example shown above? Well, we go from 0.00234, move the decimal point 2 places, and it's 0.234%. Now that's the relative error expressed as a percent, which is called the percent of error. Okay, so let's look at the chart here that I have for examples. If you have 18,000 miles, what is the precision of your measurement? Well, the precision is to the 1,000th place, because that's where your last significant digit was. What's the greatest possible error? Greatest possible error is your precision divided by 2. 1,000 divided by 2 is 500. What's the relative error? The relative error is your greatest possible error, which is 500, divided by your measurement, which is 18,000. So all I have to do is divide that out. 500 divided by 18,000 is 0.0278. Now the percent error is just taking that relative error and moving that over 2 places, or 2.78% is our percent of error. So you should try these other ones on your own and see how you do, and then you could come back and check. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 places, or the precision of our measurement is there. To the 4 places out is the 10,000th place. So what's the greatest possible error? Well, it's going to just be, you're going to add a 0 and make that 5, but we can do it on a calculator. There's no reason why you have to be able to do it in your head, but you'll start to see whenever you're dividing something like this, there was 4 zeros and a 1. Nope. Couldn't remember what we had. 3 zeros and a 1 divided by 2 is going to give us 4 zeros and a 5. That's how that always works. Add a 0 and make that last number 5. And that's what's going to be half of one of those decimal numbers. And now the relative error is the greatest possible error, 0.00005, divided by our measurement, 0.0034. And I've been going out to about four places. There's five up there at the above. I don't know to tell you exactly where to go, but you don't want to go too far out there. 3, 4, 5. The computer will tell you where to round that, by the way, if you're putting into the Math Excel program, 0.0034, and I would tell you on a paper test. So let's take that to 0.0147, and then the percent of error is two places over, or 1.47% is our percent of error. So we have a lot of things that have the words error in there: greatest possible error, relative error, percent error. But relative error and percent error are just the decimal version and then the percent version. So that's not too bad. The precision of your measurement here is to the 1/4 place. What do you get if you take half of 1/4 or you're going to divide by 2? Remember, dividing by 2, this is the precision. I'll just leave that there. The greatest possible error is, I'll put it over here, sorry, 1/4 divided by 2. And when you divide by 2, it's like taking 1/4 times 1 over 2, or in other words, 1/8. And that's something that we had you do in the verbal fraction test, was find half of this, find twice, double that. Because when you have to find the greatest possible error, you're really just cutting that fraction in half to find the greatest possible error, because dividing by 2 is like multiplying by 1/2. Well, now the relative error, we're going to take 1/8 and we're going to divide by, I'm going to change this into 12, 13, 14, 15/4. And that means that instead of dividing by 15/4, I'm going to actually multiply by 4/15. Yes, I could have made my boxes bigger. Don't know right now why I didn't do that. But anyway, 4 goes into itself once and into 8 twice. And 1 times 1 is 1 over 30. 1/30 is our relative error. Well, what is that as a decimal? All you have to do to find that as a decimal, to change that into a percent, is take 1 divided by 30. That's going to give us this 0.033333. And if I move that decimal place over 2 times, I get 3.33%. Maybe you recognize that 0.33333 repeating is 1/3. A great way to write that would be 3 1/3%. That would be, I would accept either answer there. What's the precision of this one? Well, the precision is to the tenths place. If you divide something like this decimal that we saw, what we're going to end up getting is an extra 0, and we're going to change that 1 to a 5. It always happens, but you don't have to remember that. You can put it in your calculator, but if you're out somewhere and you don't have a calculator, that's something to think about. When you take something like that and divide it, you add a 0 in front and change that to a 5. The relative error is 0.05, and we're going to divide by 195.6. This should be a very small number, right? So 0.05 divided by 195.6 is 0.12323, rounding to four places like we've been doing. Now if I go over two places, I have 0.03%, which is very small percent error. The relative error is actually very small as well. So that's the first half of that lecture. I'll see you next time for the second half.